You've heard of twins, but what about spontaneous triplets? You heard that right. No IVF, no fertility treatment whatsoever, just a big surprise at your OB ultrasound, like this couple.
Shut up! No!
What's it today? Yeah, you guys!
Oh my
congratulations.
God!
Congratulations!
I literally, I can't even.
Let me just see if I can get another picture.
What happens? What happens?
So.
So this is Ashley Henson, and she and her family have shared their journey on Instagram and social media, and I've gotten a lot of questions from you guys in the community about, could this possibly happen? Can somebody have a surprise triplet pregnancy? And so I wanted to explain that for you today. I'm Dr. Lora Shahine. I'm a double board certified OBGYN and reproductive endocrinologist helping people build families for 20 years. And I've never had spontaneous triplets in my practice, but it can happen. And I'm going to teach you all about it today. I love educating. And there are two other ways to get in touch with me and learn more. One is my weekly newsletter. There's a link in the description below. I give you fertility in the news. I give you fertility facts and I share recommendations every week. The other way to stay in touch is my podcast, The Brave and Curious Podcast. It is such a joy. Every week I publish interviews with experts in the field or fertility warriors, or I do a deep dive into topics that you ask me about. So I love teaching. And today we're going to learn all about spontaneous triplet pregnancies. We're going to talk about how it can happen. We're going to talk about how common or rare it is. We're going to talk about a real life story of spontaneous triplets. And then I'm going to cover some really important educational information about how risky multiple gestation pregnancies can be and how monitoring and sort of care could be if you find yourself in this position. So let's get started. So as soon as I saw some videos from the creator Ashley Henson and her beautiful family, I noticed she had triplets, and a lot of comments were asking like, oh, did you do IVF, or, you know, how did you get triplets? And she's been very open about that it's been a spontaneous pregnancy. Such a joyful person to follow. I highly recommend checking her out. But then with her sharing her story, so many people have asked me, you know, hey, Dr. Shahine, like, how can this possibly happen? And I can't wait to share with you, because there's three ways that spontaneous triplets can happen. I did not go to art school. I went to medical school. But let me explain how spontaneous triplets can happen. The first way is that one egg and one sperm can turn into one embryo, and that embryo can split and then split again. So these are spontaneous identical triplets. This is very, very rare. So one egg, one sperm turn into one embryo, and then that embryo can split. So it has the same genetics. And then one of the other embryos can split again. So there's one, two, three embryos with all the same genetics because they came from the same egg and sperm that implant into the uterus. The second way spontaneous triplets can happen is three different eggs and three different sperm. So someone could ovulate one, two, three eggs, and those three eggs could fertilize with one, two, three different sperm. And those eggs and sperm turn into three different embryos, all with different genetics. These are fraternal triplets, and they all implant and turn into beautiful babies. The third way spontaneous triplets can happen is a combination of the first two methods, in which one egg and one sperm turn into one embryo that splits, and a different egg and a different sperm turn into its own embryo. In this situation, these two embryos are identical, and this is a fraternal embryo. And this is the way Ashley Henson shared that she conceived her spontaneous triplets. So how common are spontaneous triplets? They are rare. Twins occur 1 in 250 pregnancies. For spontaneous triplets, any combination of these methods, 1 in 10,000 pregnancies. And for Ashley Henson and the way she conceived, this third way, which is a mix of identical embryos and a separate fraternal embryo, 1 in 3 million chance. So that is rare. And that is why I have personally never seen a case of spontaneous triplets in my practice. But I've definitely heard of it. I've had colleagues that have had spontaneous triplets. I've even had patients that were spontaneous triplets, like they had two siblings. But I haven't seen anyone conceive in my own practice with spontaneous triplets. A real life story is Ashley Henson, and she has shared her journey. It was her third pregnancy. So the couple already had two beautiful children. They were excited to add to their family. But wow, what a surprise to get to your OB ultrasound and find out you're going to have not a family of three, but a family of five, and spontaneous triplets is your most recent pregnancy. What a surprise. So while triplets are amazing and this family is beautiful, a multiple gestation pregnancy comes with serious risks. In pregnancy, the mother is at a higher chance of having complications like high blood pressure or preeclampsia of pregnancy, gestational diabetes or blood sugar issues, a much higher chance of delivering by C-section. I actually am not aware in my 20-year journey of anyone delivering vaginally triplets. It has always been a C-section in my personal experience. And the most common risk is preterm delivery and all the complications that come along with a preterm birth. So lower birth weight babies being delivered before the lungs are fully developed, really spending time in the NICU, having a hard time kind of with that early development. And quite honestly, sometimes not all the babies make it. And so it's really important to get excellent prenatal care with a lot of extra monitoring, more ultrasounds to really monitor the growth and development of the babies, and working really closely with a perinatologist or a high-risk obstetrician to figure out the safest time to deliver, very likely to be on bed rest or even have admission to the hospital in the late second trimester or early third trimester, just for that close monitoring. Absolutely, everything can be wonderful. And, you know, these triplets that we're talking about today seem to be doing just great. But I really want to caution people that that's not always the case. One of the best parts of my fellowship at Stanford was spending time in the NICU because I was able to really see the complications from multiple gestations. And as an IVF doctor, I'm often counseling patients on the number of embryos to transfer. And our goal is one healthy baby at a time. Twins are adorable. Triplets, you might think like, I've always wanted a big family and it's just so great to have, you know, siblings that are so close in age. I can see that romantic vision and that sort of desire, but the risks are extreme. And our goal, again, is one healthy baby at a time. So the vast majority of the time when we do have control over number of embryos to transfer, we're transferring a single embryo. And that's for the health of the mom and the health of the baby. So I hope you helped. So I hope you enjoyed learning about this rare but amazing spontaneous triplet pregnancy, a little bit about how it could happen, some of the risks that are associated are really important to remember. If you found this video valuable, be sure and like it, comment with questions that you have, and be sure and subscribe to my channel so you get my weekly videos all about reproductive health. And until next week, wishing you love, luck, and pineapples.